Shy away from reality and remain unconcerned about the devastating effect of poverty in Nigeria daily. The root of poverty lies in the deprivation of people's access to necessities such as food, healthcare, and sanitation, education to say the least. The sky just stares us in the face. Poverty surrounds us, more glaring in the suburbs of the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja. It is no news that Nigeria has overtaken India and is currently the poverty capital of the world. What perhaps is new is that Nigeria's frightening poverty statistics, instead of diminishing, is increasing day by day. According to the National Bureau of Statistics, the number of people that live below extreme poverty as of April 2019 was 91,501,377, making Nigeria the world capital of poverty. As if that was not bad enough, at the moment, 6 months later, the number had jumped to 94,470,533 people. What this means is that we have added 2,969,158 people into extreme poverty. By comparison, this number is more than the population of the Gambia and Cape Verde combined. The logical question in this light of the above is, how can Nigeria be lifted out of poverty? The government has promised to lift 100 million Nigerians out of poverty over the next 10 years and set them on the path to prosperity.
For us, we granted that each of these are just being signs. As citizens, if we're able to concentrate on just two, the road and the power, I think we'll go a long way.
Lifting 100 million Nigerians out of poverty is just a convenient catchphrase to give the impression that the government is doing something. As Nigeria joins the rest of the world to commemorate the International Day of Eradicating Poverty, the fear, however, is heightened. At the current rate, Nigeria is not only off track to meet the Sustainable Development Goals, but many now believe that up to 25% of the world's extreme poor will leave in Nigeria by 2030.
The 2020 budget is expected to accelerate the pace of our economic recovery, promote economic diversification, enhance competitiveness, and ensure social inclusion. We are optimistic of attaining higher and more inclusive GDP growth in order to achieve our objective of massive job creation and lift many of our citizens out of poverty.
The high rate of poverty in Nigeria has been attributed to the unprecedented level of corruption in government and largely affecting all spheres of society. Many believe the president has not done enough.
There are no evidential proof to show that this government is committed to eradicating poverty. Rather, the government is complicating and compounding our poverty situation by going and borrowing. Nigeria has become like a debtor nation. Nigeria is all over the place going everywhere, cap in hand, begging all conceivable creditor all over the place, China and the rest of them.
Over the years, the following factors have largely contributed to the high rate of poverty in the country. These include corruption, lack of education, poor medical care, unfair distribution of material resources, among others.
So why do you want to increase the tax on these people that are already there without basic amenities and further impoverish the entire nation? If the government is broke, let them tell us they're broke and find other ways to fund the budget. Again, we're also doing debt management and paying huge amounts on it. we need to look at other sources of making money, other sources of collecting this tax, not on the common man that is already paying excessively.
President Muhammadu Buhari has promised to lift over 100 million Nigerians out of poverty before the end of his second tenure. But Nigerians hope this won't be the usual rhetoric. Roots TV Nigeria.